Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's
I'll do my best.
Gate.
If none are better.
Everybody. Venturing forth once again. Some more adventuring to be had. It is hour one. By the time we get to where we want to be, it will be morning or daytime in any case. So where have we not conquered? Where have we not explored? We have cleared out. Yeah, that's over there. We have cleared out this area. We've cleared out the friendly Armin area. Just a bunch of... a few... hobgoblins, I believe. So cleared out here and here. Let's head back here. And we also have this. I think this is where... I don't know if we can head there. Let's head there. I think this is the ambush where... Garion was killed. Who's this? Yep, there's the ambush site. So we might as well clear out this area. If ever there's a first level area, this would be it.
If none are better.
But of course, looks can be deceiving. Binkos? Have we spoken to this Binkos?
Hmm?
Sorry, chum, but I can't stop the chat. There's been another caravan raided northeast of Baraghost, and I must report of these dire straits to the Grand Dukes. The messenger's work is never done. Imowen says, another caravan raided? Wow, that's no good. Remember those flaming fists passing by Candlekeep last week? They said there was at least two missing. I think we should keep our eyes peeled, or we'll be killed by bandits for nothing. Exciting, though. Caravans, bandits, road. Like an adventure from a book. Just keep your heads down and keep your weapons handy. We will endeavor to do so. Alright, in the meantime... let's head south. Oh, yeah. Xzar, or Xzar and Montaron, I remember them. I remember them well. Candlekeep Coastway. Hail, friends.
Montaron, you are so aggravating! She's disturbing to my demeanor!
A child wandering the wilderness? Surely you must be none too bright to be traveling these roads. And you look a bit scuffed, too. A fine pair of troubles all your own. Indeed, I can offer you healing potions if you wish, as a token of goodwill. Imowen says, psst, Sapphire, the mage speaks like he's laying honey on bread, but I don't know. I don't like his eyes a single bit. I'd be grateful for any assistance. Nothing to fear from these simple potions, and I'll not even hold you in debt, though your conscience knows otherwise. Just like all good people, so we gained a potion of healing. Perhaps as payment you would go with us to Nashkal. It is a troubled area, and we mean to investigate some disturbing rumors surrounding the local mines. Some acquaintances are very concerned about the iron shortage, specifically where to lay blame in the matter. You would be useful, though I'll not hold you to it. We are to meet the mayor of the town, a man named Baron Gastkill, I believe. Your conscience be your guide. Montaron, talking about conscience all the time. We'd have to drop one person, right? Because they come together. I would join with you, but I must meet someone first. Perhaps you will go with me? We've precious little time, but it's best to travel accompanied. I don't like the looks of these two jokers, Sapphire, Imowen says. Nope, I don't. Not at all. Let's get to the Friendly Arm Inn soon, huh? I'd like to have some people I can trust traveling with us. Yeah, they are traveling with us. Montaron says, aye, we'll go with you. You owe us for our time, though. Alright, remove party members. Now, what about all the stuff that we have on her?
Something troubling you?
Xzar and Montaron wish me to travel to Nashkel. Xzar says, you're letting me go? But we've shared so much. So many good times. Yeah, hold a second. This is truly a sad day indeed. Goodbye, so sad, blah blah blah, and all that rot. Come along, Montaron, you are my counterpart, and we shall not be separated. So they do hang around. We gain gold 7. So, yeah, luckily she doesn't have much. Take the healing potion. And I'm sorry, but I did buy this sling for you. We'll take that as well. Of course, Nero, you're free to keep your special staff and your robe. Alright, so now, let's try this again.
What? A simple matter?
Is ambrosia.
You came back. Oh, I just knew you would, especially after what we shared. What was that again? Oh, pish. No matter. All that is important is that we are back together as one big happy family. You too, Monty. Let's go. As much as your mental state unnerves me, I do have need of your company once more. Hurrah! I'd have us all sing with joy, but I'm sure such an outpouring would come dangerously close to making me sick. Onward and all that. Okay, dropping Nera. Xzar has burning hands. Does she have anything to say?
Seriously? After all we've been through? Obviously, I had the wrong idea about our friendship. When you're ready to apologize, you can find me at the Friendly Arm Inn.
Yeah, sorry, we need more party members, and these two only come as a pair. So perhaps we'll meet again, Nera. Also, if we need her, we know where to find her. So, yeah, got another person with 4 hit points.
Stop touching me!
And he's kind of insane. So he's got Larlock's Minor Drain and Chill Touch Scrolls. He has a dagger. Now, I'm pretty sure these guys are not going to be permanent members. That's full. Did we forget to sell some stuff? I guess so. They're not going to be permanent members. They're going to be permanent members for a while, anyway. Because they're... Well, they're kind of crazy. He's a necromancer. Montaron is a thief, I believe. Yeah, there he is in all his craziness. Chaotic evil. Now, the fact that we also have true neutral. But Khalid is neutral good. And Imowen already doesn't like him. is all his stuff. When asked about his past, I don't know how to pronounce his name, Xzar? Xzar? I always called him Xzar when I used to play this. Xzar has very few coherent things to say. His desire to determine the cause of the iron shortage seems benevolent enough, but his motives remain unclear. His rumblings seem disjointed, but his faculties are obviously in good enough order for him to be adept at magic. He mutters something about how he and his associate Montaron are in the employ of a powerful group, but when pressed for details, he gets extremely agitated and does not speak for some time. He's obviously at least partially insane, and the network that would hire him must be dark indeed. Okay, and then Montaron, yep, is a thief level 1. Here are his skills. When asked about his past, Montaron openly threatens you with bodily harm. He seems quite dangerous and more than willing to engage in gratuitous violence. It would appear that he cares little for life, including his own. He works grudgingly with Xzar, even though he obviously despises the man. Whoever their employers are, they must be powerful indeed. These two would likely kill each other without a presence over their heads preventing it. Montaron might be willing to discuss the whole matter with you, but you get the feeling that you would probably not wake up the next morning. Interesting. So what does Montaron have, actually?
You spoke at me?
All his lines. So he's got an oil of speed, and he's got a short sword. Studded leather armor. Since we didn't sell stuff, might we have better armor? I don't think thieves can use shields. Can they? Oh, apparently yes. There you go. Improves his armor class by 1. Short swords. Can't stack those anymore. Yeah, we're not gonna be using that thing. Stacking stuff. What is this? A potion of agility. Yeah, I should have sold some stuff. We don't have that much. If there's anything, I'll drop the skulls. Okay. If I talk to them, they say anything.
I'll do your toil.
Wait a second. He's talking.
Yes?
I want to talk to him.
Such menial tasks.
Xzar's eyes shift wildly. Not a single object or person is capable of keeping his attention for more than a second. So I guess he has ADD or something. Finally, he produces a vial from his pouch and starts shaking it. Murky liquid inside turns emerald green and bubbles up dangerously. You figure it would be best to involve Xzar in an amiable conversation before he unstoppers that cork. I can observe him, ask him lots of personal questions. Inquisitive questions about his past. Friendly and kind manner. How about in a friendly, kind manner in hopes of making him confide in me? Well, my good friends, perhaps you'd like to know a little more about me? I'm part of an order known as the Zentarum. We've been sent to learn why the Zentish name has been slandered along the coast way. It would seem that someone has been trying to make our order look bad. I actually did not know that about him. So can you tell me more about yourself? Now, my dearest Sapphire, why would you distract me from this stirring mustard jelly and slime cross? It has been dead for a decade, but thanks to the wonders of necromancy, it still maintains its freshness. Here, sniff it. And stoppers the cork, you know it. You knew it would have been best to avoid it as the noble-born slime oozes over the brim. Any suggestions, Xzar? He says nothing, but his face lights up with such manic glee that you hurry away from him before he can answer. Are you there, Xzar? Ah, sweet dreams are made of this. Well, who am I to disagree? I observe him for a little while longer. You notice him looking around nervously as if he were planning something. I'm not sneaking cookies, Mummy. And the nightshade is on the night table, just where you told me to leave it. Nightshade, hmm? A little something in case Mummy wakes up peckish in the middle of the night? Certainly not. No, you misunderstand. The poison is not for Mummy to use, that is, she knows it's there. She wants it to be there. Has she told you why she has such a particular requirement? Of course not. She's Mummy, isn't she? I mean, it's so obvious, really. She may come calling at any moment. She'd want to be prepared, wouldn't she? This is pretty interesting. Any suggestions? Certainly, help to subdue all of creation to Mummy's will, all the little bits she hasn't got already. But don't ask me how to do that. I do not concern myself with trifles. Okay. Montaron? Is that him? Yes. Montaron grins at something you cannot quite comprehend, but at least his face does not look as predatory as usual. Perhaps he can be more forthcoming with personal information than usual. You're used to hearing things from the bottom of people's hearts, so you try to charm Montaron in telling you more about himself. I were a baby boy in me family, if you need to know. Respectable halfling hall, I. Me papa didn't like me stealing, he didn't. Gave me to militia to impart discipline. Ha! Huh. Found myself a family that does not spit me way. You will see. I'll get out of field work to head torturer in one of Zent's deepest dungeon, me will. What do you know of good old torture? Can you tell me more about yourself?
I warrant your attention. Oh, frabjurous day, Kalu Kale.
Huh. You're the scout, Monty. He is. Any suggestions? Uh-huh. Flea baths. You look grumpy, Montaron. Grumpier than usual, I mean. Well, we only just met him. Is something wrong? You talk too much. You need a second mouth. Bright red and a bit under the one what you're using now would do. So friendly.
I warrant your attention. Oh, frabjurous day, Kalu Kale.
Alright.
This better be good.
See, he doesn't have a lot of hit points. But I don't have any more ranged stuff that I can give him.
Something troubling you?
Alright.
You have need of me? If none are better.
Saving. Continuing on our way here. Oh, right. Forgot to check this.
Your voice is Ambrosia.
Yeah. Okay, he knows. Larlock's minor drain. The wizard drains life force from the target and adds it to her own. The target creature suffers 4 damage while the mage gains 4 hit points. If the mage goes over her maximum hit point total with this spell, she loses any extra hit points after one turn. So he knows 2 of those. He also can memorize Burning Hands and Chill Touch. So he's got scrolls, and he's got the spell memorized as well. Okay.
I could do no other.
I'll do my best.
Anything else to be found here in this area? Let's check out over here, clear out this area. And then we'll head up north. Absolutely nothing here. Shall we see if one of the books we have are good enough? This is back to Candlekeep. And they wanted a valuable book to enter. Since we're over here, maybe we can enter.
If none are better.
What is it?
Calm yourself, dear. We must proceed carefully.
Do you think we'll ever settle anywhere, my dearest? Sometimes I feel drawn to go on, seeing where the next turn in the road takes us, serving the cause of goodness. Goodness? Oh, and balance, of course. How could I forget balance? How could you indeed? But at other times, I want to find a place to stop, to plant a garden, to make a family, centered in their being as creatures of dual heritage, and taught by their mother to be proud of everything they are, and taught by their father to do what they must without counting the cost, and to know the difference between true strength and appearances, no? Khalid smiles. Yes, I hope one day that our chance will come to us. What should we call our first son? Our firstborn will be a daughter. We druids have such knowledge, you see. Then she will be as beautiful, wise, and strong as you, and she'll be my joy, my dear love. Okay, very nice. Continue.
What? Such menial tasks.
A doormat.
We do have a book. I guess the books I have are no good.
Can I help you? I can, but try.
I mean, possibly one of the other books might be valuable enough. Do we have... Jeez. Do I have on me the one that Firebeat Elven here gave me? History of the Dead 3, yeah, I do. Alright, never mind.
You have need of me? I can, but try.
Calm yourself, dear. We must proceed carefully.
But I beg your pardon, but it would be good if we could go to Nashkill in the near future, if you don't mind.
I can, but try.
Yeah. depending on your... what you think of as near future. Let's go up the center here, or near the center. Some unexplored areas here. So far, not coming across really much of anything here. Hitting tab to highlight any selectable things. Not finding any of those either. Nothing out here. Let's check up northways. Ah! A diseased gibberling.
Oh,
I was just about to say for the fallen. Well, that was easy. Thirty-five experience spread among five ways. So I'm guessing there's six of us actually. Yeah, this is as many party members as you can have in your group. Not a single one more. So Sapphire and M1 could have taken on a diseased gibberling. A lot more dangerous here. I don't want to leave the area. Almost done mapping out everything here. Well, not mapping out, but for lack of a better term, clearing out. How pretty. What a unique vista. Ah, this was the person. My apologies for ever said this, I forget your name. Beat back some more. Yeah, we're done. Spotted this man standing here, Chase.
Yes?
I did not see him.
Fine.
Don't touch me! I might catch something.
Hello. Well, I was about to tell you not to come any closer, but that never seems to work, does it? Well, regardless, it should remain true. I should remain true to the genre. Don't come any closer or I'll jump. Yeah, you heard me. And I'll do it, too. So, Don't come any closer, again, and don't try to stop me. Then Wynn says, hey, you know what? Sapphire over here was just locked out of her hometown without a penny, and some monsters killed her father. If anyone here should be jumping cliffs, it's her. And you see her jumping? So what's your problem? No, by all the gods, do not do such a thing. There is so much to live for. You're right, of course. What a fool I was to think that this would solve anything. It didn't solve anything the last time I stood here and was stopped, nor the time before that. I really should develop a better method of dealing with adversity. It's such a long walk as well. Perhaps if I had Mumsy construct a cliff closer to town. Ah, well. Thanks for your concern. Ta. Emmeline says, I'm glad you tried to talk him out of it, Sapphire. Even if he was just looking for attention. Never mind. Must go. Much to do. You look over at Imowen and notice that she picked up the Assassin Tarnish's spellbook and is reading it. I'll scold her. Imowen, leave magic to those of us who are trained in arcane arts. When little rogues start fooling around with magic, they end up in trouble. Oh, Sapphire, the great Archmage, thy... Quit worrying already. I think I can understand some of it. Though this stuff is kind of complicated. Xzar says, complicated? Nonsense. 'Tis clear as a stream of the purest lymphatic fluid. But why concern yourself with such matters when there are experts such as I to attend to them, dear child? Well, because I'm kind of interested in magic, I guess. Guess? Then you must wait until you are certain. The art requires severe and ceaseless self-discipline. Yeah, sure. I am pleased that my example has imparted that, at least. Now, where's Monty? Oh, well, I suppose you've pawed it thoroughly enough that you would have triggered any extant wards by now. Wards? Of course. All prudent mages trap their spellbooks against intrusion, and many imprudent mages do so as well. Such lovely, sparkly colors, and the remains sometimes contain items worth the bother of picking them out of the goo. Thanks, I think. Hey, I think I've got this one down pat. Yep, easy as pie. Hold on, Sapphire, this'll be fun. Why do I have a bad feeling about this? Watch this! Hexo Presto! Shabadoo? Oops. We gained an item called Imowen's Artifact. I wanted to...
I'll do my best.
Grab this guy again, but no, he's gone. Imowen's Artifact. I guess Imowen has it? Huh. Imowen had created this by reading from Tarnish's spellbook. She's quite proud of her accomplishment, even if nobody is quite sure what exactly it can do. It's a quick... Okay. Can I use it as... Okay, I don't know.
What is it?
Should I talk to her about this?
Such menial tasks.
Imowen seems a little quiet for her. Funnily enough, you do not know all that much about your oldest friend. Perhaps this is a good time to find out what Imowen is all about. How's this adventure going? I never knew adventuring could be so boring most of the time. I was never it was never like this in those stories I heard. I'm just so bored. I want something interesting to happen. Want to know a secret about me? Well, I always was in love with Hull. Hehe, you shall see your face. Gotcha. Alright.
Can I help you?
I'm done here.
I can but try.
So this whole area, besides Xzar and Montaron, all we found was a diseased gibberling and a man who apparently seemed to want to kill himself but just wanted attention. Of course, that's not my professional opinion. I guess we'll be continuing on from here. I don't see a need to rest at this point. We have a lot of...
You have need of me?
Inventory space, not with him, but... Or with any of those, but... Here, some, and plenty here. So, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode.
Yes?
And always, seek adventure.